Hey, this is Fafa Pico. You're watching Talk DOOP with Ryan.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Talk DOOP with Ryan. And today I'll be previewing the Union's game versus Orlando City. This game will be back at Talen Energy Stadium, which we've been away from for quite some time now. It's been about a month since the last game at Talen. If you guys remember that amazing game versus Red Bull. So it's been a while since we've had a game at home. Since then, we've had four games, one being an Open Cup game, and the other three being away games in MLS. So the road trip went okay for the Union, I'd say. Started off with a 1-1 draw versus New England. I'm not going to get too much into how that game went down, but I could say it could have been 3 points, could have been zero. So I guess it's not a terrible result, but you know, it's a team that's under the playoff line. I think maybe you might want to pick up 3 points against that team. But hey, you can't win every game. But then we go on to that game against NYCFC, who have been surging lately, and quite honestly I thought we were gonna lose that game, but we came out good in the first half, and then my prediction was correct, we did wind up losing. But that's not to say that referees kind of did make some controversial calls that, you know, maybe swayed the momentum to NYCFC. We were winning 2-1, and then there's another penalty call that's just like, is this really a penalty? I mean, Bedoya comes in, uses his body correctly. I think it's a good defensive play, but, MLS refs are always subpar, so you're going to get some good refs, you're going to get some bad ones, but in our last game against Orlando, down in Orlando, I think the referees nailed the two red cards correctly. Here's the video of the first one, and it's denial of an obvious goal scoring opportunity, which is, I think it's a clear cut red. I didn't really see too much backlash on Twitter about that, and the second one's just a clear cut penalty, red card. That's, anywhere you go, they'll say that's a red card. If that was Union guy, my Union bias wouldn't even kick in there. That's a clear red card. And here's the video of that one. Yeah, so Sasha Kljestan, he will not be available, and Robin Jansen will not be available also. So two big players for Orlando, their center back and their attacking mid will not be available. But that's not to say Orlando does not have a good team besides them. You know, they're not the greatest, they're below the playoff line right now, but, you know, they have Nani, who's played with Manchester United and Portugal. So, you know, he's played with Ronaldo, Wayne Rooney, so really big name guys there that he's played with. And that's not to say he's not a big name player either. He's not the fastest player, but, you know, he's got skill, he can pass very well. They actually took Nani out at halftime against the Union on Wednesday, so I guess they're preserving him for this next game, but and also taking an attacking player out for a defender. But luckily the Union came out on top of that game. Jamiro Monteiro, yeah, unfortunately got injured on that awful tackle from Sasha Kljestan. So one of our biggest players in Jamiro is going to be out for who knows how long. Definitely going to be out for this game against Orlando. But hopefully he'll be back after that, because he's been so good for us this year, and we cannot afford him to be injured for the whole remainder of the season. That would be awful. So, Jamiro, not available for this game. Ilsenio is getting back to being ready for this game. Hopefully he is, but Jim Curtin said he's questionable, which I'm not going to say we really need Ilsenio that bad, because the attack has actually been pretty good. Jamir obviously did help it, and he won't be available for Saturday's game. So, yes, maybe we do need Ilsenio. But I think Brandon Aronson did a pretty good job in his minutes. Fafa and Kasper, I really like that striker matchup there up top. So, I like the lineup that we had out there. We started off the game not very well, but we ended it on a good note. So, hopefully we can carry that momentum into tomorrow's game. Marco Fabian, I think we might see him in the starting lineup for the first time in a while. That would be good to see, especially for Marco. I know on Twitter there's a really good tweet. I forget I forget who had it. It was Marco Fabian hit some kid in line for Space Mountain with one of his shots. So Marco's shots were a bit inaccurate, and that tweet sure did emphasize that. But Marco, you know, it's just about him getting back in the swing of things. During the season, he looked pretty good, but it's a new league for him coming back from an injury. So Marco, I think we will see him starting at the 10 on Saturday. Other than that, I think not too many other lineup changes. Madungen and Bedoya, Aronson in the midfield. I think they're going to go with the same striker matchup. I like Shabilko and I like Fafa up there. Both were the scorers for the Union. And, you know, the back line's been solid, I think. You know, Trusty, people are, there's been some backlash for him, but maybe give McKenzie a shot, maybe give Aurelien Collin a shot. Maybe Trusty needs a game of rest. But that's all right, because the Union hopefully will pick up 3 points tomorrow. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time on Talk Doop with Ryan.
Hi, this is Chris Pontius. You're watching Talk Doop with Ryan.